he let me ride in it over the hotel. Never been in there. And we got to the Rolls and I was in the Rolls Royce, and the fellas wanted to bat me. And I stepped out. He thought I was a ball player or something. I stepped out. I said, "Now you see how you get it, don't you? Bring it back the same way." And I told Doc, I said, "Doc, listen. Somebody can get the grill off your car. Somebody can get that R&R emblem, that angel, and put it on a Toyota."
They can't?
Yeah. Some of y'all cars are you know y'all can get them. They can get the RR, that's what it has on the emblem, and the angel. And they can get the grill, and Dan, they can even get the wheels and put on a Toyota. And at first glance down the street, you'll say, "Yonder goes a Rolls Royce."
Mm-hmm.
But if it fooled you at first glance,
yeah,
all you got to do is lift the hood.
Talk.
And when you see that Pee Wee motor, I wish I had a track.
Yeah.
You know that ain't no Rolls Royce.
That ain't no Rolls Royce.
What you're saying, preacher, I'm saying to you that there are some churches that look like the real thing.
Yeah.
But if you lift the hood,
yeah.
You see a piano,
yeah.
You see an organ,
yeah.
You see a woman up here preaching.
Oh,
you
yeah.
See no communion juice.
Yeah.
No communion. It ain't the one.
Right.
All
right.
So on some of this stuff, all you gotta do is lift the hood.
Yeah.
If you're looking for the church.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
That's in the Bible.
Right.
You see, we said names don't matter. The folk that tell you that don't believe that themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you something. I was preaching a meeting in Dallas, Texas, a few years ago. A lady came up to me after my dissertation. She said to me, she said, "Listen, you sound reasonably intelligent." And so Rodney had sent out your bio and promoted. She was a member of the church. And she said, "I thought you were smart." They said you was a counselor and you used to work in heart surgery and you was medically trained and you preached in 34 states and 3 countries. "I thought you were smart." She said, "But I found out you're about as ignorant as the rest of the Church of Christ." She told me that she was just going, "Hey, you know me. Now you get some only problem." Now, you know, call me ignorant right there in the church office. She said, "You about as ignorant as the rest of the Church of Christ preacher." First of all, I said, "Well, first of all, ma'am, I'm not a Church of Christ preacher."
Yeah, talk preacher.
I wish I'd see y'all.
Yeah,
come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
You need to know that too. I'm not a Church of Christ preacher.
Yeah.
I'm a gospel preacher.
Yeah.
Preach what the church wants to preach.
Yeah. Right.
I don't preach what the church, I preach what the Lord authorized.
Right.
Yeah.
That's fresh of all.
Thank you.
And I said, "Why do you call me ignorant?" Obviously, you can tell I have some level of intelligence, yes, that I have gone by the schoolhouse. I didn't stay long, but I drove by. She said, "Well, you go around saying that a name, there's something in a name. A name don't matter. In church, it don't matter what you call it, it's what you got in the heart. And you too intelligent to be telling folks it's something in the name. It ain't nothing in no name." I said, "Well, perhaps you're right." I said, "I'm sorry, I bid you well, Sister Jezebel."
Oh.
What did you call me?
Yeah.
I said, "I bid you well, Sister Jezebel." And I really want to go to my street and get a name.
Yeah.
I had a sharpened knife with me. But I just said, "Listen, God bless you, Sister Jezebel." She said, "My name ain't no good. What you trying to say about me?"
Uh-oh.
I said, "Oh, ain't nothing in her name."
Yeah.
Ain't nothing in her name.
Right.
And so she saw it.
Yeah.
Right then, she saw it because she was honest. And they were baptized.
Hey.
Oh. Honest folk, when you show them they're wrong, they'll get it right.
Yeah.
This honest folk, a whole lot. You ever seen a drunk with his wine bottle?
Yeah.
He got cirrhosis of his liver.
Mm-hmm.
It's killing him. Bloodshot eyes.
Mm-hmm.
He homeless. and he's holding on to the bottle and say, I can quit any time I get it. See, this is for the whole thing of that which is killing him.
Right.
Even when you're short, that's what's good.
Right.
Now, some of y'all don't have, in the church, we don't have cirrhosis of the liver. Once we come to the church, we got cirrhosis of the giver.
So, what? Preacher.
Listen, the Lord built one church. I got to tell you that. Don't get mad with me. Oh, I left my pointer in my office. Okay. Now, let's see how we adapt to that. The Lord built one church. People walk. I started this on Wednesday night. This is why I preached. Wednesday night, I started dealing with the church and the Bible. It was interesting, provocative, and informative. So I decided to segue to what I'm doing today. Somebody said this, but you know, well, in the Bible, it says go in the church of Christ, and it does. Church of God, church of Christ, body of Christ, all of these are descriptive names for the church. But it's still talking about the same church.
Right.
It's still difficult, but no, you didn't get that. So
yeah.
I thought you might not get it. So I prepared myself in case you didn't get it. Fellas, help me show them what I mean. There is only one and only Wesley Taylor. In case you didn't get the memo, maybe your fax machine is broken. There's only one Wesley T. Leonard. One and all. Only one. Shall never be another. Now, how you got it wrong? It's the wrong one. It's the other one. Don't be in that one.